Just last month, I told you about how a huge ridge of high pressure, nicknamed the Death Ridge, was going to form in the center of the country and lead to what we call an Omega Block. And this was supposed to act like a storm wall that kept energy away from the eastern U.S. And for the most part, that's exactly what happened. But now, that Death Ridge and the Omega Block are literally falling apart, and a new, rare weather pattern is taking shape that will cause several unexpected problems as we go towards the middle of June. This all starts on Saturday, as we expect a large area of severe weather to break out in the southern plains. In fact, the Storm Prediction Center has already issued an enhanced risk of severe weather for over 8 million people, highlighting the risk for large hail, damaging winds, and maybe even a tornado or two. And this is significant because this is the easternmost elevated risk of severe weather the country has seen in nearly an entire month. Now, don't get me wrong, we have had no shortage of severe weather over the past month, but things have been pretty dry east of the Mississippi River, and the intensity of the severe weather we have been seeing is subpar. Did you know this May was the fourth consecutive May without a violent tornado? This actually breaks the record of three consecutive Mays between 2000 and 2002. I mean, there was not a single report of wind, hail, or tornadoes in New York or Pennsylvania for the entire month of May. And the thing keeping the storms out of the east is the result of the infamous Death Ridge and the resulting Omega Block pattern we were left in because of it. In a previous video, I talked about how it was going to act like a wall in the middle of the country, keeping most of the action away from the east. And that's what happened. We've seen lots of energy slam up against this wall, causing all sorts of problems from Texas up through New Mexico and the Front Range, and we've actually even had flooding problems as far north as Montana. But nothing has been able to pierce this wall in order to bring significant severe weather to more eastern regions of the U.S. until right now. You see, the Death Ridge is falling apart, thanks to multiple systems embedded in the jet stream, which has taken direct aim at the ridge's weakest point. The first system that's going to come in this weekend is just going to chip away at the wall, making easy work for bigger systems in the future to come through and literally tear it down. Essentially, the part of the Death Ridge that was stopping the progression of the storms will open up, and this is going to allow the storms to pass through more frequently. But even the smallest disturbances along the jet stream right now will be able to cause big storms because there's so much energy lying around down here this time of year. And that's exactly why storms will be possible from Oklahoma City all the way down to Shreveport on Saturday. But the action will continue into Sunday as well as a result of our dissipating Death Ridge. Warm and very moist air will be in abundance across the mid-Mississippi and Ohio River valleys as a pulse of colder air pushes in to create thunderstorms. And these storms are going to be daggone strong, capable of producing hail and damaging winds. But we really have to watch out for the potential for a couple tornadoes as well. Just look at how the lower level jet winds increase right around sunset here. This is going to add just enough spin to these storms to potentially cause a tornado or two. These storms will also be packed full of rich Gulf of Mexico moisture, so we really have to watch out for flash flooding as well, especially where the storms train over the same areas for several hours. But as we go deeper into the overnight hours, these storms are going to quickly fizzle out, until they fire right back up again farther east on Monday. More severe thunderstorms with isolated tornadoes will be possible from South Carolina up into the southern Mid-Atlantic region on Monday. Current guidance shows these storms really ramping up during the heating of the day, and once again, there's going to be a slightly robust lower-level jet in place to help those storms spin. But the threat is just a little bit too far out to pinpoint specific details at this time. And that's not even the most interesting thing that's happening on Monday. A bigger, even more powerful trough will be forming in the west and setting its aim on the central plains. This is the one that's going to tear our wall down. This could lead to several days of significant severe weather, as this is a big, long trough that's going to take its sweet time progressing through the country. And this seems kind of strange if you're somebody who's been paying attention to the weather in this country for the past several years. The jet stream is not supposed to be hanging out this far south. It's supposed to be way up north this time of year. The fact that we're seeing actual troughs dig through the southern U.S. right before the official start to summer seems downright uncanny. And to an extent, it is. There's so much energy down here that throwing an active jet stream into the picture could be recipe for disaster. But it's actually not unusual at all. We've just forgotten what it's like to be in an El Nino after three whole years of being in a La Nina phase of our ENZO. The jet stream has moved north. So far north, we can see it chilling way up here in Canada. What we are dealing with down here is the subtropical jet, which gets amplified enough to make it to the U.S. during El Nino phases. And it makes a whole lot of sense that we're seeing this pattern unfold now because we are officially in an El Nino. So get ready for even more stormy weather as we go forward, because this is just the start of El Nino, and its effects on global weather will only become more evident as we go farther into 2023 and 2024. Currently, one of the more concerning signals coming from the models in relation to this passing trough occurs late next week. Around Thursday, the 15th, a final push of our trough develops a significant divot and charges into a huge plume of moisture from the Gulf of Mexico. This is the kind of thing that we would expect to see in early spring, not June, because this little divot is going to contain a sharp burst of cool, dry air that would initiate an anomalous severe weather outbreak. And this time, there's going to be more than enough spin in the atmosphere to cause multiple tornadoes. Some of them could even be violent. If this actually occurred the way it's being modeled, this would be one of those days where we have to go live here on the channel for up to 10 hours straight relaying warnings. I hope that ends up not being the case, but our storm chasers are rested up and ready to go just in case we need to provide coverage. But it's very important to keep in mind that this is over 170 hours away. The models cannot predict the weather with any sort of accuracy at this distance. However, the signal has been consistent enough, and it's so strange that it deserves some attention. Whenever the models show the same thing over and over again, even when it's far out, it's my responsibility to let you know what could be coming. So for now, I say don't be scared, be prepared. We've had some quiet weather here recently, but it's time to get back into hypervigilant mode. Severe weather is going to return to a large and populated area of the U.S., and we're on the verge of the tropics starting to pop off as well. In fact, there's actually been a very consistent signal for some sort of tropical system to make it into the Gulf later this month. This is also too far out to really dive into right now, but the Gulf of Mexico is off the charts warm for this time of year. So if anything does actually form down here, it's going to explode in a bad way. The best thing you can do is just make sure you have all your plans in place so you and your family know exactly what you're going to do when a warning comes through. And it would not hurt at all to have a good radar app. And I know you've heard me talk about them before, but I cannot recommend Radar Omega enough. These guys have been the biggest supporter of this channel since the beginning, and I've been an avid user of their products since long before anybody was willing to sponsor me. Guys, this is the same app I use to guide millions of people through severe weather every season, and it doesn't matter if we're talking about tornadoes, hurricanes, blizzards, or flash floods. And you can have the same daggone thing on your phone, iOS or Android. It is the most customizable and quickest updating radar app on the market. With the most recent update, it has officially become the best all-around storm tracking app. And that goes for general concerned weather-prepared citizens and seasoned weather fanatics like me. It's fast, it's smart, it's technical, but most importantly, it's simple. You can have it right now by clicking that link in the description. This is potentially a life-saving tool, and I promise you, you're going to love the functionality of it over any of the other radar apps that you've tried before. So yeah, there's a link in the description, and that's all the weather I have for you today. Guys, things are ramping up, so make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn notifications on, and get ready for more frequent updates. I appreciate every single one of you, especially our channel members. Thank you guys so much. And of course, I will see you in the next one. Goodbye. Ooh.